To be honest with you, I'm going to say something outrageous.
It was vintage Joe Biden, outspoken as ever at an event marking the 19th anniversary of the Violence Against Women Act, blasting Republicans for trying to block reauthorization of the law last year.
But surprisingly, last year, we ran into this sort of Neanderthal crowd that, No, I mean it. No, I'm serious. I mean, when you think about it, I mean, did you ever think we'd be fighting over, 18 years later to reauthorize this?
The vice president and possible presidential contender is known for speaking his mind, sometimes raising eyebrows.
You cannot go to a 7-Eleven or a Dunkin' Donuts unless you have a slight Indian accent.
At Thursday's event, before a crowd that included advocates for women, he talked about getting ahead of President Obama last year when he went off script to announce his support for same-sex marriage, comments that later prompted the president to do the same.
Certain things I promised I wasn't going to keep my mouth closed on, okay? So I make no apologies for jumping ahead on the issue of marriage.
His latest remarks come as speculation about the 2016 race heats up. This weekend, Biden heads to Iowa, the crucial early battleground that dashed his presidential ambitions in 2008. He'll speak at a steak fry hosted by Senator Tom Harkin, an event considered an important stop for any Democrat aiming for the highest office in the land. Biden hasn't yet said he's running. He was supposed to headline last year's fry, but couldn't make it, and aides say he's just honoring his previous commitment. But what if he is a contender? How he stacks up will depend a lot on whether another also-ran, former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, decides to give it another shot.
I have a very hard time imagining Joe Biden running against Hillary Clinton for a variety of reasons, not the least of which is that it's very difficult for, I think, for a candidate starting from where he does to beat her.
Now, one thing I can tell you, Wolf, is that we will be keeping a close eye on Vice President Biden while he's in Iowa this weekend. And I should add that on Monday, he's set to visit the port of Charleston in South Carolina. South Carolina, as you know, is also an early voting state, so make of that what